Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for having me here today at WOW Digital. It's such an honor to be part of such a movement in Southeast Asia. And we'd love to share more about some of the things that we have been working here at OSA. How do we use AI as a voice beyond machines to really create impact in people's lives? I would love to get started with my presentation and do a little bit more sharing about what we have been working on over the last few years or so. So very quickly, as the host has just introduced, my name is Vu Van. I'm the co-founder and CEO of OSA, which is an AI for English language learners around the world to improve their English speaking skill. Before I share more about what we have been working on and what the product is about, I want to share about the story about why I started the company. So as I mentioned, OSA is built to help language learners around the world improve their English speaking skills so that we can give them better opportunities in their lives. And as a Vietnamese person growing up, I had been learning English for 20 plus years, started in school. You know, just for a lot of us growing up outside of the English speaking countries, you don't have to convince all of us that, hey, English is important. It's gonna give you a lot of doors and opportunities into your futures, right? But very much similar to a lot of people learning English and spending a lot of time and money, what I struggled when I first moved to the US about 11 years ago to pursue my MBA and my master's in education here at Stanford was that when I started speaking, people had a really hard time understanding me. And it was not because I didn't know English. I had learned English growing up. I could be reading really well. I could be writing really well. I probably know a little bit more English grammars than an average American just because I spent 20 plus years learning English grammars and every single textbook. But when it came to speaking, people didn't really understand me easily. And every time I spoke, people would be saying, hey, can you repeat that? Excuse me, can you say that again? And it happened over and over that it really hurt your confidence. I withdrew. I didn't feel confident that, hey, I should be speaking up more in a very large environment, right? I feel a lot more confident in a smaller group of other international friends like myself, but less so in a bigger environment. And as soon as I got misunderstood. And for that experience, I realized that I'm not alone in this journey. As we know, there are more than $65 billion that people have been spending in learning English. Out of all of the 1.5 billion English learners around the world. And so the challenge happened to a lot of people, including myself. And one of the biggest research that I learned during my years at Stanford was that when people speak English with a really strong accent or they struggle to speak confidently and fluently, people are trusting you 30% less. And that's mind-blowing research fact for me because, and you know, and people do it unconsciously. It means that they're not intentionally trying to discriminate against you or anybody else. It's just that somewhere when you don't speak fluently, then people trust you a little less. And definitely there's a lot more data out there that say when you speak English really well, you can easily earn 40% more. And for a lot of other developing countries, that income difference could be 2 times and 3 times as much. But this challenge is not only just an individual challenge. As you know, companies are now these days global. There's very rare that you have a meeting that is just like everybody speaking English as a native language, right? And so when you have such a global workforce, everybody sitting everywhere, companies are reporting a lot of challenges due to miscommunication, 32% loss of clients. They spend more time in meetings, productivity reducing. Some meetings supposedly take 30 minutes now have to take like 45 minutes because everybody had to speak a little slower. And so there's a lot of those impacts at the company levels as well as the individual level. That's why about 4 years ago, together with my CTO, we built OSA, as it stands for English Language Speech Assistant. And the idea is that we want to help people speak really good English using an AI tool that can listen to everybody and then give them very detailed feedback. So when we started the company, we built our proprietary speech recognition technology using deep learning and machine learning. We didn't use a Google API, Alexa, and Siri because of a few limitations. These technologies would understand native speakers much better, but when it comes to people who speak really bad English, these big technologies might not understand them easily. And then the second is, even if these technologies might be able to understand these different accents, it's harder for them to pinpoint exactly the mistakes that people made. And as a language learner myself, I realized that, hey, you can tell me it wrong all the time, but until you tell me why I made the mistakes and how to fix it, I wouldn't be able to improve that. So as you see on the screen here, what we then did was we created our own technology. We're collecting voice data from people around the world who speak bad English with different accents, and then train our machine so that it can be adapted to people who come from different accents, whether that's a Vietnamese person speaking English, whether that's a Malaysian person speaking English, a Japanese, an Indian, a Brazilian. And then based on that, the technology go deeper. We detect the pronunciation errors at various levels. We go as deep as the phoneme level, which is an individual sound. As you see the word here, let's say we gave you the word cup, and you might be saying cook. So we're highlighting the sound in the middle and we say, hey, that middle sound, is mispronounced. And we see the feedback hint on the top that would just basically say, how should you pronounce that sound correctly by moving your tongues or your lips in different position so that you can improve that mistakes. And you try it again and again, you can listen to the simple voice, you can then record it again and compare your own voice and then get all of these instruction as it's adapted to the mistakes that you made. And then we do this for individual word, a sentence, a paragraph, and anything. And we're teaching you all of the different styles in English, all of the different skill set, whether that's your intonation, your rhythm, and even your choices of words that you're going to be saying in that sentence as well. And so in the approach that we do is that using this AI, we will then also be able to build a very adaptive learning methodology where we initially place you in an assessment test. And then through that one, we learn more about you and as you spend time in the app. And then we build a customized learning path for you based on all of the challenges that you have, right? Similar to if you watch Netflix, they're going to rely on your history of everything you watch so that they can recommend the right thing for you to learn. And for us, it's the same thing. We track every single progress along the way, every single exercise is being recorded so that we understand what areas that you improve and what you don't improve in your entire speaking journey. And in addition to that, what we then also do is instead of teaching people with just very standardized like curriculum where everybody learns the same thing, we build a very flexible and dynamic content platforms. And again, we base on who you are as users. Are you here because you love to look for a job? What kind of career interest are you in? And then we send you different contents that might be relevant to you. That content could be for professional interest or could also be for personal interest. As you can see on the screen here, let's say the seasonal festivals are happening, like Halloween just happened last weekend, then we send people all of the content that related to that topic so that people can learn different contents that they can hold in their daily conversation as well. And these contents we launch every week, we partner with different contents. And again, using our AI recommendation engine is tailoring this experience for you so you'd never feel bored and you never feel like you're learning something that's not relevant to you. And that's the idea, so that we can help you improve better, right? And a huge improvement from our users' experience after 3 months or so. Definitely people speak more clearly. We measure the pronunciation score in the app, and we see a huge improvement just after 3 months. And most importantly, what we are very proud of is that, you know, as everybody said, when they don't speak well, then they're not confident and they stop speaking. And as we measure some of the satisfaction score at our app, 95% of the users reporting that they feel actually much more confident as they go out and be willing to speak to other people. And, you know, it's a chicken and egg problem, right? Like if you start speaking more, then people are going to feel more confident and then they're going to be able to practice more and so on and so forth. And that's the key for us, is that how do you feel more confident and empowered as you go out using English as a communication language? And so we measured that. We launched a product about three and a half years ago. So the first 2 years of the company, we primarily focusing on building the AI and the voice recognition technology. We're collecting data from people around the world, training the machine so that it gets better and better. Right? At the beginning, it probably doesn't understand you as well, or it only understands certain accents. And now we actually cover pretty much all sort of accents that we can understand very well. And since then, we also have seen the product has grown very, very well organically over the last few years or so. On average, we grow about 3 to 5 times a year. We're right now recording about 11 million users around the world users coming from 100 different countries. That definitely Southeast Asia is the biggest concentration right now because we launched in Southeast Asia first as a market that I'm from. And so I understand the market the best. But we started seeing more traction in other parts of the world like India, Japan, Latin America as well. And we'll continue to push the product and make adaptation as we go to different markets. And for us, COVID has happened this year and definitely has changed a lot of the way how we build businesses, but it's also emerged different opportunities in education sectors around the world, as you might have heard about. Students are stuck at home. Online learning becomes much more than just a trend, right? It's a paradigm shift that now enable parents and students to see online tool as an integrated part of their learning. And with that, we actually also see a big impact in our business. Historically, we have been focusing a lot more on college students and young professionals because it has a direct impact on their job opportunities as they graduate. With COVID happening, we also started seeing a lot more students around the world in K-12 markets. And so starting beginning this year, amplified by all what happening in COVID and education areas around COVID impact, at ELSA, we started extending our solutions to offer to schools and companies around the world. So in addition to a direct consumer product, we now also building all sort of tools and dashboards where teachers can integrate their own content onto the platform, keeping track of the students assigning homeworks. Companies can also customize the curriculum. If we are working with a company in the banking industry, we now build the entire curriculum that just serves that banking industry. And so it's different verticals that we're going after. And I think, opportunity to learn online is going to remain to stay COVID or not going forward. And we are very, very fortunate to be a part of this entire movement, how we can use AI to really enable changes in real impacts that can actually make a lot of differences in people's lives. And that's what we have been working on at ELSA in the last 4 years or so. And look forward to hear more about the stories from people around the world and how you use AI to change people's lives. Thank you so much for having me.